What's up, Dallas? The Mighty Nine. It's time for another one. So, can Star Wars be saved? This is a question that many have asked over the years since the destruction of Star Wars that started in 2012 when George Lucas sold it. Now, we fast forward to right now. We are over a decade of them owning this product, or the franchise, I should say. And we fast forward to right now, and we have Dave Filoni now being promoted to Chief Creative Officer. Now, I will admit, I like the Clone Wars. I even liked Rebels, right? I gave Rebels a shot. But over time, we've seen where the focus really is, right? Dave Filoni really is focused on, like, Ahsoka. Let's be 100%. That's what he's really focused on, is Ahsoka. And he did well when he had George Lucas, who is the creator of this, giving him direction. That's why Clone Wars was pretty awesome. It had some flaws, but it was pretty awesome, right? Overall. But will this help fix Star Wars? I gotta tell you, there's no amount of them trying to patchwork this up for me to give them a reprieve, I should say, right? It's not gonna happen, because I'm still standing by. You never put Luke, Han, and Leia in a scene together, and we can never have that ever again. So from that instance alone, you can never fix that alone. That, to me, is Star Wars never getting fixed. But let's take a look at the situation Dave Filoni's in right now. So this is from Variety.com. So Dave Filoni is now in charge of Star Wars at Lucasfilm. Yay! Dave Filoni, who has overseen Star Wars, The Clone Wars, Rebels, The Mandalorian, Ahsoka, and is the master of all things in a galaxy far, far away, according to you. Now has a new role in Lucasfilm, Chief Creative Officer. He still holds the title of Executive Vice President, which he received in 2020. So let's skip right down here, right? So this is Dave talking right here. It says, in the past, in a lot of the projects I will be brought into it, I would see it after it had already been developed in good ways. He said, in this new role, it's opened up to me basically everything with what's going on. When we're planning the future of what we're doing now, I'm involved in the inception phase. But here's the kicker. I'm not telling people what to do, but I do feel I'm trying to help them tell them the best stories that they can do and that they want to tell. I need to be the help across the galaxy here, like part of the Jedi Council, almost. So, if you're not telling people what to do, how are you helping? Because right now, this is the biggest problem, that nobody's telling them what to do. They're doing whatever they want. And a lot of people say that the EU, and I bring this up many times, the EU had to be more streamlined. That's why, they didn't want to pay people and they wanted to tell their own stories. That's why they got rid of the EU. But it needed to be streamlined, right? Kind of sort of what they were trying to lean towards, right? When the EU really was, quite frankly, way more in line as a story, lore-wise, canonically-wise, can't talk, and, go forward. Whereas everything we have now, raised nobody, then she's a somebody. She's this, now she's a Palpatine. We're doing the Mandalorian. Oh, we fired Gina Carano. So now we have to change this, and then we have to do that. It's because you never had a real plan to begin with. And the other problem is you're trying so hard to make people like it, right? And that's what you're doing wrong. Instead of putting out something that you know people would like, I don't know, you could have kept the EU. You're trying to make things up out of the fly and try to force people to like what you put out there. That's not how fandom works. just because something is being pushed doesn't necessarily mean something that we're going to like, right? And I think another problem with this is the fact that you're trying to make us almost a connected universe, like a MCU, like when the MCU was supposed to be everything connected, which that's trash. But that's besides the point. But I think if you guys are just to make a story, right? Like, have a plan for a story. Make one story, right? Have that plan for, like, your trilogy or whatever, right? Then once you're done with that, then you build off of that. I don't know. Kind of like how the original trilogy was made. It was these three movies put together. Beginning, middle, end. And then from there, we got the EU. And then we got the prequels. And then we got more EU. And then all that stuff built off of that. Rather than saying, hey, let's make this thing and make everything connected. And by doing that, you're spreading yourself too thin. Rather than focusing on one thing and getting that straight and then building off of that. But you don't have to take my advice because, you know, multi-billion dollar company, guy in his office. I know you don't want to hear what I'm saying. But hey, whatever. Just a fan since, I don't know, the early 80s. But you don't have to listen to me. But other than that, you know, the fact that he said he's not going to be telling people what to do, and you can see with it, not telling people what to do is giving us right now, have at it. You're not going to get any money from me. I'm done with you guys. But that's neither here nor there. But anyway, how do you feel about Dave Filoni becoming the chief creative officer? Do you think this will give us some changes, or do you think it will be the same nonsense? Let me know in the comments. Like, share, subscribe. If you want to support the channel, you can hit that super thanks. And remember, you can't be good, be good at it. Peace. I heard that the best bet is Monopoly.